Hi, it's Steve, and what did I tell you at the end of our last video?
I'll be back.
That's right. By that cutaway and the title, you pretty much know we're going to be starting Agora Models T-800 half-scale model. Half-scale, that's 37 inches tall. It has lights. It's posable. It looks like it's going to be a lot of fun, because if you've followed along on my channel, you know that, you know, I love robots, and, well, other than the B9, which is the best robot, this has got to be the second best robot, or Android, however you want to look at it. This first pack includes 10 stages. So what we're going to do is we're going to put all the screws away in our little bins here, and then I'll bring you guys forward as always, and we'll start building this. Stage 01, we're going to be starting off with putting the eye sockets in the faceplate here. So we'll get these out of the packages, and then we'll start building. Now, as we're taking these out, there's three screws that come with this stage. And unlike some of the other projects, they're not numbered like DM or DP or anything like that. They're actually something to do with their size, I would assume. So it's a PB2 by 4mm, and that's exactly how I labeled it, is a PB2 by 4mm. So we're going to drop these in here. Now, reading the directions, since this doesn't include a screwdriver, it does say you need a long screwdriver or some of the parts to reach in and engage the screws. So I have a long shaft screwdriver right here that I use, and we'll be using that as our screwdriver. Okay, we'll start off with stage one. Now, throughout this kit, you're going to receive certain parts that you're not going to use in the immediate build you're doing, and they just want you to put them aside. And for this part, that is the faceplate, the skull faceplate, and this, what they call the nasal socket. Right here, you don't need these two parts right now, so we're going to put them aside. And what they do want to start building with is the actual eyes. So we need to take one of the LEDs and one of the eye sockets, and you push them, slippery little suckers, and you're just going to push that right in one side, one end of the red LED. As you can see, it's flat and it's got a hole in it. That's the part that goes in, and it just pushes in just like that. And we do the same for the other one. There we go. That's it for step three. And step four, it says to do the other one, which we already did. Okay, step five has us putting the LEDs into the eye orbits right here that we did in the previous step. Now, there's pins on the back of the on these eye sockets, I guess, if what they want to call them. What you want to do is you want to hold those pins up and down so they're vertical. And the LED wires also need to be vertical. So they basically go the same way as the pins. And then you just push the LED into the eye socket. You want to be real careful because you don't want to break the leads off from the LED. So that's one done. Now we're going to do the other. We've got to push a little hard. And like I said, you just want to be careful, they will go right in. Okay, so those two pieces are done. Okay, now, one side of this eye holder here, there's two pins and then there's one pin. What you do is when you hold the piece like this, so this is the top, you want to orient it so the two pins are up top. And there's only one pin on the bottom. Two pins up top, one pin on the bottom. Okay, so we're going to do that with the one. And we're going to do that with the other. May need more than one hand. And that gets held in there with this little piece right here. Okay. And it is a concave shape. It's not perfectly flat, so it follows the shape of the this eye socket piece. As you saw, I had a little bit of trouble there getting this sitting there, so Let's just go get our helping hands. Again, two pins go up, one pin goes down. And then it gets held in with this piece right here. Okay, now what I'll do is I want to make sure that those pins sit in the recess of this plate, which they do, and the eye should rotate back and forth like this freely. And there's the extra pin on the top. And these get held in with two of the PB2 screws that we had over here. There we go, and they are held in there. All right, this stage is complete. Now we are moving on to stage two. Okay, as we were taking the screws out for this stage, they put all the screws in one package here. They're all PB2 screws, but six of them are 4 millimeters. I'm sorry, six of them are 6 millimeters long and three of them are 4 millimeters long. And the only really way of you telling that is simply to lay them out against each other and see the size difference. Luckily, there's only two different sizes, so it's easy to pick out. So we did 4 millimeters in the previous stage, so we'll just put them in the container we already have. And for the 6 millimeter, I created a new bin for that one. And we'll put them right in there. Now, what's nice about this is they do include a spare. You only really need four of the 6 millimeter, but they include an extra spare. And you really only need two of the 4 millimeters, but they gave you three. So that's handy. So in case you drop it, you've got them right there. So I'll put the screws aside. And here are the pieces. We're going to be working on the arm and the teeth. So step one is they want you to take the right arm component A, and you don't really need this one right now. I'm reading the directions, so we'll put that up here with the rubber components for use in a later build. Step two, we're going to be bringing in the upper jaw, and we're going to bring back part of the eye assembly we did before. You want to keep this tab to the top. This is going to fit in right in here. There's registration pins, so it fits in real nice. And under here, right here, and there's another one here, those get these 6 millimeter long PB2 screws. Okay, so that's in there. Now there are two more holes right here. The other one's here. And as we turn the page, we're going to put two of the 4 millimeter screws right in there. So now you can see they're all in there. And of course, there is the upper jaw with the eye socket. And now we're going to need some super glue, and we're going to need some toothpicks. Now what they're going to want us to do is with the toothpicks is so we can place them very delicate. We're going to be doing some dental work. Probably didn't think you were going to be a dentist, but here you go. All right, so we have our super glue right here. We have our toothpicks right here that we're going to use to apply the super glue with. And like I said, the reason we're going to be doing that is we are now going to move on to putting the teeth onto that jaw assembly we did earlier. Now what's very important, as I don't think the camera's going to be able to pick this up, but each one of these sections of teeth have a different number. They're labeled 1, 2, 3, and 4, and you need to keep track of those because they only go in certain parts in the jaw, so don't mix them up. So we're going to use our side cutters here, and what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take them off. As you can see, here's the instructions on putting the teeth in. If you hold the jaw like this, it's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I'm only going to take off one section of tooth at a time. So I'm going to take off
one first, and I'm using my flush cutters. Or you can use an X-Acto knife. If when you're taking this off, you find that there's a little bit of leftover plastic or flash in there, you can file that down, but these look like they came off really good. So I'm gonna dry fit them first. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is take our super glue. Take a small piece of paper here, and I want to put just a little blob of super glue in here. And they're telling you to use gel, which I always use anyway because it's way easier to control. It doesn't flow all over. So I'm going to take a toothpick here. I'm going to drop it on right here. And you just want to drop right around where the registration hole is on the jaw. You want to put a little bit of that super glue. And one, I'm going to turn it this way, so make sure I don't get it in the other hole. Right there. And now I'm going to put the teeth in. Okay, and I'm just going to hold that for about 30 seconds. Now they are concaved. Okay, to match the bend in the jaw. So you want to be careful when you put them in there, you're doing it the right way. I am. Okay, so that one fits in real good. Again, I'm not going to put them around the hole because I'm afraid this hole here is for the tooth we're about to put in. This hole is for the next one. I'm afraid I'm going to get some glue into that hole sooner than I want. So I'm just actually going to put a drop of the super glue between the two holes for this section of teeth we're doing. That will hold it. So there's a little glob of super glue right there. Okay, I'm just lightly rubbing my finger along all the teeth, and they are in there pretty solid. So here we go. A little hideous looking in it. All right, we're going to put that skull assembly aside right now. And now we're going to be doing, while that dries, we're going to be doing some arm assembly. So we want to take the right arm components, B, which is, where is that, right here, and C, which is right here, okay, and you want to put these together. This is pretty easy, but what you want to do is there is a notch right here, little recess right here, and there is another recess on this piece here, right here. They need to line up, so that's how you know you have them aligned right. There you go. So now there's one big recess. All right, and now these are going to get held in with two of those 6mm PB2 screws, but as you can see, there's a depth in there to get to that screw. That's where this particular screwdriver I showed you comes in handy, because we can unscrew this, pull this shaft out, and then we can easily get to where we need to be. So we're going to get a couple 6mm screws here. Okay, and this stage is complete. We did part of the upper arm and we did the face. So now we move on to the next stage. Now we're moving on to stage 3, and I want to take a moment to talk about this. Is I'm going to skip ahead a little bit in the book or in this stage to the fingers. They have modified how they do the fingers so it's a little bit better. It can hold the weight of the gun that's included that's going to be included in this. So what they did is, on the back of this pack for stage three, there is a package of screws and joints, or actually not screws, they're just joints and some plastic pieces that are going to supplement the pieces that are in here, and I'll show that to you when we get to there. But you want to be careful then when you get your pack three, or your pack for stage three, that you don't toss it away, because they, like I said, they just scotch taped this additional parts on the back here. Step one, we're going to take some components here, which are the right arm parts 3-1, 3-2, and 3-3. And these are all metal. And let me take this piece right here. We spread all the ones all over the place. All right, this, and then 3-6. I'm going to go over to my little legend here to see what 3-6 is. It's a mystery. Oh, here it is. Oh, 3-6 are two PM3 8mm screws, which I have already put away. Right here, there are some hefty screws right there. 8mm screw right here. I'll put it onto the end right here. I'm then going to put through this piece here. And then put through this piece here. And then just screw that right in. That was fairly easy, and we are going to put this aside for a future date. Now we're going to move on to the battery pack, and they want to make sure that it is set to off, which it is, and they want us to remove the screw that's on the back here. So we have access. And it just slides right off. And like I said, you need three AAA batteries, which we'll go get and put in. Okay, so we're back with our AAAs. And now we just slide that right back on again. Put the screw back in. That was super simple. Okay, step five is us putting the screw back in. And step six is they want us to take this, looks like a power distribution board right here. And they want us to plug battery box that we just put batteries in into here. Okay, and then they want us to take, there's only one connector on here, so they want us to take one connector of the eye, plug that in, and then they want us to turn this on, battery box on, and there you go, one eye lights up. And they want us to take this off. You have to be very careful. Make sure you pull on the connector, not the wires, because you don't want to pull the wires out of the connector. And now we plug the other eye in. And again, we turn it on. And that eye lights up. Okay, we'll put the face away, put the battery box away, and then we're going to move on to step 9. And this is where it tells us to, before proceeding, to read the important update on page 14. So we'll go back a couple pages right here to 14. And that's where it's telling us they want us to use these new spare parts right here, which I'm going to take out of the bag. So I'm going to bring this up to here so we can see. So it wants us to take one of these parts right here. Okay. And included in your modification kit or envelope were some plastic pieces, and you're going to fit one of those plastic pieces over top of the shaft. So what I did is fit that plastic sleeve right over the shaft of those parts that were included in those, in that addendum kit. And there's two others, so I'm going to put them on the other two, and then we'll move on. Okay, so we're going to be doing it. I think we're going to be doing a finger. So they want us to lay these parts out, which are 3-7 through 3-11. And they made up, if you look at how you lay them out, you know, they each part is all set from the other. Okay, and what they get held together with is those parts we just did in the modification kit right here. They want us to take some super glue. And this looks like it might be the tip of a finger right here. And it goes onto this end, and he wants to super glue that on here. So he wants to put some super glue around the shaft. Just put it lightly around the shaft of this fingertip here. Then we take the actual fingertip and press it right on there, and the super glue will hold that. Here's all the arm pieces laid out, or the finger pieces laid out. Here are the T connectors we did in that modification pack with the plastic sleeve over top. And then we're going to take out these little like pins that were in the modification pack. And what's going to happen is these pins are going to go into these T connectors after we insert them through the fingers. So that's what we're going to start doing right now. So here's the finger we just glued up, and we're going to take this, and we're going to, holding it like this, the first one goes through here. Okay, so I got the pin with the plastic sleeve that we did through there, and what I did is I actually took some Rap-A-Tap, which is, you know, or you can use 3-in-1 oil, and I put a little bit of that inside, around the inside of the hole, and it slid right through because it was pretty hard getting those in there. It was really a snug fit. So what I'm going to do now is I've got the one finger joint right here. Now I'm going to put the other one right here. And we'll leave them laid up like that. Now they want us to take one of these pins, and what they want us to do is put some super glue around the edge of that pin right there. You can see it. I'm applying a very, very little amount because you don't want to lock. Now, after the pin's in place, I'm going to hold it for 30 seconds. But while I'm doing that, I'm going to periodically move the finger joints, because what I don't want to do is, if any super glue did get on there, I don't want it to take hold on there. Now we're going to move on to the second joint. And I'm just making sure it looks exactly like it does in the picture. And it does. So we are good. That stage is complete. We did one finger, and we did what is most likely going to be an arm piston. Stage four, we're going to continue with the upper arm construction. Stage four, and we're going to continue with some upper arm construction. So step one is pretty similar to the cylinder we built before. We're going to need a PM3 8mm. And slip this part over. Oops, there it goes. And we screw it onto this part right here. Okay, so that part is done. Now they're gonna have us bring in this part right here, which is an arm rod. Looks like a little T-piece right here. And they include some rubber washers in here. And I'll put a closer picture of this in post. But there, one side of the washer has a wider opening. And it's a recess for this little end of the shaft right on here. So it can go, as you throw this around, it goes right on there. And that's going to get held in with a PM2 4mm. Now the important part when you're putting this washer on is not to over tighten it. You want it snug only. There you go. So that is on there. Okay, so now you have this piece here with the washer on the end. This is the piston you just completed. I don't know what the difference is, but they want you to put this one away, and they want you to bring back the piston that we completed in the earlier stage right here. And you can tell because one is, the one we did in the previous stage is shorter. And what they do is very simple, is they want you just to take this washer shaft you just did and put it right up in there. And that is it for step five. We'll put this aside. And they want us to take this other arm rod, which almost looks like a clevis pin. And they want to do the same thing. They want us to take the other washer that was included in this kit. Again, noting the wider opening here that goes onto this here. And you again hold this on with another PM2 4mm. And that is it. Now it wants us to bring back the piston that we did in this stage. And just like the other one, we just put that right in there. And there you go. Now, it wants us to bring back, looks like a rotator cuff for the arm right here. I don't know what they're calling it, but that's what I called it. And if you notice, there's a little nubbin right there. Okay, and they included these two rubber pieces right here. And if you turn them over, you can see that, and put them together, or maybe I'll put them right here. There's a little bit of a semicircle cutout on the one side of these. That goes down on this. Okay, here's the cutout. So it just slides right on like that. And then the other one slides on like that. So what they want you to do is take the piston assembly, and we did with the clevis type end on it right there. And they want us to take this part that was included in the stage. I'm going to orient it just like how they have it right here. They want us to put this on our work surface like this. And they're also mentioning a 20mm screw, a PM3 20mm. Okay, so they want us to put this part like this. They want us to take this right here. There is obviously a hole right here. Right here. And he wants to put the 20mm through there. Okay. I'm going to put my finger over here so it doesn't fall out. And then he wants to put the piston notch over there. Now what I think we're going to do is take their expert tip advice, and we're going to ask for a piece of scotch tape or 5 extra points if you know where universal bonding strip came from. And we're just going to put that over that hole like that. So when we flip it like this, the screw doesn't fall back out. So we're going to keep that there. Then I want to take this other piston we did, and while my assistant over here gets us another piece of universal bonding strip, we're going to take the other 20 millimeter, I think it is. Now I'm lying to you. We need a 16 millimeter screw. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing as we're going to put this through right here. And we're going to take another piece of scotch tape right here. We'll just put that on there, keep that. All right, so then we take the other piston, lay that over top here. Okay. Okay, we bring this rotator cup back in, or whatever you want to call it. The little plastic pieces we put on have to be on the top and the bottom. So it has to fit into this little hole down here. And to be perfectly honest, I'm going to put this one in all by its own self. And then I'm going to put this part in. Now take the part 2-3, which was supplied in stage 02. Or stage 2. That's this part right here. And they want us to flip this down and over. And again, you see there's another mating square right here, recess for this top part of the plastic that we put on there, or that rubber. And we are going to put that right on top here. Okay, this knuckle can't sit completely perpendicular to this arm. It has to be rotated a little, and then the pieces fit right together. So then we turn them over like this. I'll take the scotch tape off on this one side, and we'll screw it in. And there we have it. The one arm assembly is done. And that completes this stage. Stage 5, we're going to be doing the lower jaw of the neck. These are all the pieces we're going to need. So we're going to build a little bit of a ball joint first. We're going to take these two pieces right here, parts 5-4 and 5-5, and we're just simply put them together. Like that. And there's two holes right here. Alright, we're going to take this ball joint assembly, and we're going to take part 5-1 here. Alright. We're going to orient it like this, and we're going to take this rubber type washer right here, and that's just going to go right into there. This fits right into there. Then we're going to take this ball joint that we did. That's going to fall right into there. And then there's just this little dome piece right here. That goes right onto there. And there's some registration. There's holes here, 3 of them. And 3 posts on this bottom part here, and they're going to go right on there. And they are going to get held in there with some PM2 6mm screws. And again, flip this over. You can see how you can now move this shaft, and you can turn it, or actually... So believe it or not, that was easy. This stage is done.
There's a couple things with building this that are a little bit different than some of our other builds. One, you want to keep some some super glue handy. You also want to keep your Rap-A-Tap or your 3-in-1 oil handy. You want to keep two different screwdrivers handy, a 00 Phillips head and a 0 Phillips head. And most importantly is you want to use, sometimes in order to get into some of the pistons we're going to be putting together, the distance is pretty long into those parts. So you're going to want a screwdriver that's either got a long shaft like this or one that's collapsible and expands like this. And I'll put a link to all these tools down below. So if you don't have any, I can tell you where you can get some. So the other thing also is with this kit, all the screws sometimes come in one pack. So you have to, when you start the stage, you have to look at the directions. So you have to look at the screws because you could have two of one type, two of another, and they're all in that same bag. Luckily, they all match up with the pictures that they give you in the directions. So you're good with that. But you just have to be really careful. They don't label the screws of what type they are. So be forewarned. I'm trying to think of anything else we ran across while doing this. I think if we did, most of it's covered in the build. Well, thanks for coming along and on this journey of pack one of the Agora Models T-800 Terminator model. This is going to be a fun build. As we stated through the video, we're going to make some changes. We're going to do some weathering. It'll be really cool. I highly recommend you do this build because it's really fun. And if you're following along with me as you're doing it, and if you found any of the tips I did in this helpful, be sure to hit the like button. If you want to see more of what we're doing with this kit and some of the other Gore kits, especially the Ladder 9 truck, be sure to hit subscribe. And if you want to get notified when they come out, hit the bell. So until next time, I'm Steve. Thanks for stopping by the Maker's Cave.